Don't be a kook. Okay, from whatever city you're from, because I'm from here.
This week on Monster House, our barbaric builders pounce, pillage, and plunder to turn an eclectic bachelor pad into a Viking Valhalla.
Got the thunder working.
But can they pull off this Nordic conquest in a mere 5 days?
Today has been one of my worst days in construction.
Dude, I would have bid something like
Shut
this.
Shut up, get back to work.
Do we get to vote people off?
Yeah!
Our house was plain and simple. It was safe and normal. It was nice and sweet. But we all agreed we could use a change. And then something happened that was very strange. Cause a van showed up. All our stuff went flying. And my mom was crying till the job was done. Now it's a monster house. It's a monster house. It's a monster house. And we all just love it. It's a monster house.
Meet Pete Thordarson and his roommate, Dane Wilson.
I bought the house about a year ago. I've just been tired of paying somebody else rent.
Pete is an all-American guy who's never lost touch with his Scandinavian roots.
My mother is Swedish. My father is Icelandic. The house that I lived in when I was a child was pure Scandinavian Viking.
So he's asked Steve to give his home a Nordic makeover, but his roommate's not so sure.
I don't even know what a Viking house is, to be honest with you.
Leif Watson is willing to take on the challenge, so long as our homeowners stay out of his hair and inside a Coachman fifth wheel park curbside. Steve brings in designer Todd Erlandson to help him figure out how to knock this house back to the 9th century.
All right, Todd, here we are. Peter Thordarson, the homeowner. You've got Viking blood. The guy's a Viking fanatic. Anything that's screamed Viking to you, that's what we've got to do.
All right, well, you got this long room, right? This long, narrow room.
Well, I think this would be perfect to be like the Viking dining hall. And we could just build a huge, beefy table that almost takes up the entire room.
Right,
you know, with benches all the way down.
Okay. Do kind of a post and beam construction thing. Okay, big, wide plank floor would be good.
And the Vikings worshipped, their main Viking god was Odin, and he was known to have one eye. Now, if you could do like the Eye of Odin, that'd be a good starting point right here, over the door, overlooking the big banquet hall.
You know, maybe you could even do something with this light fixture, this fan, change out the blades to paddles.
That'll be sweet. That's a great idea.
The front room will be transformed into a Viking longhouse with a stone and wood Viking banquet table and a shield and paddle ceiling fan, all overseen by the watchful Eye of Odin.
Hey, in this backyard, doesn't have anything going on, that'd be a perfect place to do a big Viking ship. I'm talking about a big, bitchin', badass Viking ship right over there, facing this way. And this is the perfect place, but this thing's gotta be bitchin', you know? Put a big, a nice table in there, give you a place to sit.
That's right, so it's gonna be 10 feet wide, 15 feet long.
Yeah, this isn't
like
a Viking canoe.
You're gonna have the sail up here with a mast, all right?
Yeah, and why not make the mast lift up like a canopy? This thing's gotta be beefy, though. I'm seeing like the bow of the ship coming up. The big dragon head up top, like 12 feet up, blowing fire. That'd be awesome.
That would be good.
Yeah,
that
I just don't want I don't want to burn the house down. No.
The backyard will get a Viking ship with a built-in barbecue table, a sail that converts to a canopy, and a masthead dragon that breathes fire.
Well, you know, if we're gonna do a ship, we may as well do a dock.
All right.
You know.
All right.
Right over there, a pier.
So you want to get an opening going here and.
Yeah, we can just blow this wall out and make this our Nordic passage.
All right, you got the pier casings coming up and you're standing up on the dock and the ship's like right in front of
That's
you.
That's perfect,
right?
Yeah.
And what about the rest of this area? Can we do something out here? Is there something that...
I'm a big fan of fire. Fire just adds life to it, just adds motion. I like to see a little more fire, so I think we should do like a big fire pit, a big cooking area right here. I think that would fit in great.
The back wall will be blown out to create a Nordic passageway and a pier. The backyard will also get a cooking area with a stone fire pit made from real rock.
Sounds good.
That's great, man. That's going to be sweet. It's a lot of work, but I'm excited.
Monday morning, and a longship appears on the horizon with this week's team inside. Eric Marjoram, general contractor. Carl Kramer, veteran boat builder. Yale Smith, jack of all trades. Ken von Schlegel, artist and sculptor. And at the helm, Christopher Dow, aka Dr. Wood, carpenter.
All right, men, let's go pillage this place.
All right. Yeah.
If their siege is successful by Friday midnight, they'll each receive tools from Makita, Aesop, and Stanley worth a $250,000 Icelandic kroner. Our homeowners emerge to surrender their keys.
Morning.
How you doing?
Good. Good, man. Steve?
You guys feeling okay? Feeling nervous?
Yes.
I need to take your keys, and I'll give those back to you at the end of the week.
There you go.
All right?
All right.
You guys enjoy the RV. All right, let's get to work, guys.
Pete and Dane flee to the coachman as Steve and his hungry horde descend upon their humble home.
You know, we're doing a Viking theme. Well, this is the Viking dinner hall right here.
Great.
So you've got post and beam design, lots of applications to the wall. We're going to build this big banquet table, build those benches. A lot of woodwork. We're gonna decorate the room with, you know, battle axes and shields and stuff. They didn't really have ceiling fans in the time of the Vikings, but we don't want to take their fan completely out of here, so we're gonna build this. This is a shield. These are some oars. It's gonna be the fan blades, so you still have some movement. You guys wanna head outside?
Sure.
Check it out. What we're gonna do here, we're gonna blow this out, put some doors there. This is basically gonna be a landing. It's gonna be our Nordic passage from the interior to the exterior. And we're gonna build basically a dock. We're gonna build a fire pit right here. Lots of rock, make it look nice and beefy.
Last project.
We are gonna build a boat. Who said something about a boat? Not only are we building a boat, but we're also building a boat that's gonna double as a deck, and it's gonna breathe fire. Oh, and you guys have to figure that out and make sure it's safe and done the right way. All right, how you guys feeling?
Good.
One more thing. There you go. 4 days, 15 hours, and 15 minutes, and it's going backwards. So I suggest you guys get in there and start tearing it up, all right?
All right.
Cool.
Well
done. Dr. Wood snaps on his bags and dives into the demo, hoping the rest of the team will follow his vision.
I don't know if the other builders are open to my leadership or my style of leadership, but I've been doing this a long time. I know what goes fast.
Outside, Carl is more focused on how to build a Viking ship in just 5 days.
I'm Carl Kramer. I live in Brooklyn, Maine, population 600. I work for a magazine that's dedicated to wooden boat building and maintenance. So this is my chance to use years of knowledge and some fast application. It's a drag being 57, but, you know, I never feel over 27.
He starts by placing concrete piers that will anchor the redwood deck frame. Inside, demoing the front room isn't quite the Viking ransack Steve had in mind.
The demo going on today is very meticulous, and the guys are a little, you know, gingerly taking this house apart. But, you know, it all depends on what your style is. Me personally, I like making a big mess.
General contractor Eric tries to light a fire under Dr. Wood.
We can make a quick straight cut down here and find out what's behind it in terms of framing.
But the good doctor prefers to do things his way.
Whatever you think.
I just want to kind of do it surgically.
Okay.
I mean, we're going fast enough.
All right.
Dr. Wood has been called to pre-op.
Rather than rip out the whole wall, Wood wants to preserve the existing studs and headers. So Eric leaves him alone and turns to jackhammering a footing to support the ship's 12-foot mast.
My name's Eric Mardrum. I'm 34. I'm a licensed general contractor. I want to do as many types of work as I can before I get old and grumpy.
By mid-afternoon, Lumber Liquidator sails in with a shipload of redwood. But out back, the doctor is still in surgery. This time, Steve tries to pick up the pace.
What I'm saying is tear the wall out.
Not gonna do it.
I'll do it.
No, not gonna do it. You'll burn me.
This entire wall has to be redone.
Right, but what I wanna do is I wanna cut where my king studs are gonna go.
What I'm telling you is this whole thing has to be reframed in anyway.
Yes, but what I'm saying, if I cut where my king studs, what I also have
you
to think about-
You are killing me, you're driving me crazy.
I also have to think of the inside of the wall.
I don't even wanna hear it anymore.
Okay, please.
You're giving me a headache.
Please, I've been doing this a long time, 25 years, homie. What I'm saying is I really know what I'm doing. When it's finished, you'll be happy. I'll make you a hero.
I don't need you to make me a hero.
Okay, well then, just let me do it.
Where's the chainsaw?
My name is Christopher Mark Dow. I'm in my early 40s. I am a construction coordinator
television, film, music video, high-end owner, builder, residential contractor. I'm a rock and roll tour drummer. I'm a hired gun to play in concert with solo artists on stage.
Dr. Wood continues to do things his way, carefully performing a doorectomy on the back wall. Meanwhile, Eric's footing is finished, and the cavity is ready for a filling.
Okay, I kind of want to go.
It's late afternoon, and Yale helps Dr. Wood cut out the existing header to make room for a door frame. But some of the drywall is damaged, and the doctor says this is not his specialty.
I hang rock, but I don't tape and mud, so I don't know who's gonna cosmetic this, or I don't know what's on here.
Oh, you don't tape and mud?
Don't touch it.
Why is that?
Gets me dirty.
Meanwhile, our shipbuilders have roughed out the frame for the deck. They realize that to support a fire-breathing dragon, the prow will need a stronger foundation.
Right now, what we're trying to do is do the groundwork that'll hold up the prow, the big, I guess, dragon's head that I'm going to carve later.
Our Dane of Design, Stuart Gilchrist, arrives for a quick scan of Scandinavia.
Really? That was a lovely sound.
Wow.
Okay. Hello there.
What's going on?
How are you? Good to see you.
Good to see you. Welcome back.
Thank you.
All right.
So let's take a look at the inside, what we're going to do.
I think it would be a great idea if we warm up these windows with some kind of window treatment. And my first thought is to do some textured Belgian linen because they probably stole them from Belgium. And I think above here would be kind of cool if we painted a serpent of some kind.
Thing. Yeah, that could look great. It's going to be a good week. If you need anything from any of these guys, don't be shy. Just grab them and, you know, get an extra set of hands.
Yale breaks ground on a new project, a dock for the Viking passageway.
So we got four posts going in here for this little deck. So when you come out of this door, you'll be stepping on a little deck.
Meanwhile, the boat boys have finished the frame for the deck. By sundown, they're ready to lay the teak down. Furniture maker Ken begins crafting the Viking banquet table and benches. The design calls for the table to have a concrete center, etched with an ancient Viking map. Dr. Wood resets the door header, then helps Yale anchor his pilings. But our boat team has lost its wind.
We can't work on this anymore tonight because we need some fasteners. So we're gonna pick up our area and see if anybody has some short-term projects we can help with.
So that was my goal. I set my goals high.
Dr. Wood suggests that they start on the fire pit.
I only get it wrong. I don't wanna start screwing stuff up. I'm about to fix it tomorrow.
Right, well, it's just layout. It's not getting a placement.
I understand. I'm saying
so you don't want
to
do that.
But his bedside manner leaves something to be desired.
If I couldn't go any further on my project, what I would do is I would start laying out another project so somebody could jump on it tomorrow morning.
Most of the team prefers to jump ship and swim home. As day one nears midnight, Yale stays late to help the doctor bring his door project into port.
Tuesday.
Radio Tower.
Here we are, day two, Survivor Monster House.
The groggy guys climb back aboard their longboat, and Dr. Wood makes an unsolicited exam.
It's real good, real nice.
But the good doctor's advice is starting to wear thin.
We probably didn't need to have a level test, but it's done, we passed. Press on.
Ken starts on a prow to hold the fire-breathing masthead.
My name's Ken von Schlegel. I'm 42 years old. I build and design one-of-a-kind pieces of furniture. I'm an artist. Built a semi-airplane that is a bookcase. All I do is do art every day.
The prow needs to be curved like a dragon's neck and also allow room for a propane line to feed the flame. Ken's plan is to construct two matching halves with a gas line running up the center. Each half will be made out of sections of 2x6, biscuited together. On board ship, Eric and Carl raise the mast. But already they're feeling behind schedule.
If this were a real boat, it would take 4 months. We're trying to accomplish this in 5 days.
Inside, Yale takes a closer look at the room's existing wiring and decides to move the Eye of Odin light from above the front door to the side wall.
I gotta tap into this plug here, pick up power, come up here and add an additional switch, and then come over to over here to add this light fixture.
Turns out this Viking is only a weekend warrior.
My name's Yale Smith, I'm 40 years old. I am a salesman, I sell high-end security systems. And on the weekend, just as a hobby, I do a lot of home improvement.
With his door done, Dr. Wood moves on to building a deck for the dock.
I got about a few more boards I gotta rip around this concrete, then we'll start running planks.
Kind of wondering about this tarp here.
Out front, homeowner Pete is beginning to worry about what's happening to his house.
I don't even want to know.
That's not too bad yet, huh?
I see window panes. The window pane sort of concerns me because I actually did sort of like that window. This is, yeah. No, yeah. I think that's exterior, but I'm not sure. I don't know.
So, basically they just ripped out the
insulation.
Wall.
Yeah, there's a wall missing somewhere along the lines.
By early afternoon, our boat builders are ready to start turning their deck into a ship. Their plan is to attach vertical ribs onto which they can wrap horizontal planks, called strakes, to create the hull. Carpenter Ken has moved on to making the posts and beams that will give the banquet hall its rustic Viking feel.
There you are, beam one.
Yale tries to lend a hand on the pier project, but quickly runs afoul of the doctor's high standards.
Hey, make sure it's flush.
Pick it up.
It's already nailed.
Oh, shoot.
Yeah, I need to not assume what people know what they're doing and just take it on myself to just go ahead and take control. It's a nightmare. I'm not gonna have fun, but I'm gonna stay late every night and do what I can.
As the sun sets on day two, the ribs are up and the decking is almost done. Inside, Eric helps Yale hang drywall.
I would cut a piece, 18 and a half.
Once again, the doctor starts poking in places he doesn't belong.
18 and a half by.
You want to learn something? The way you're gonna do it, you're gonna friggin'
I'll cut this edge here. I'll have a bevel joint there and a bevel joint there.
You can do it wherever you want, however you want, but I'm telling you the right way you do it so next time you go to some job down the road and it's friggin' high-end, 8,000 square foot custom home, you'll know how to do it and you'll know how to do it clean and make sure your seams butt seam to seam. And that's all I'm saying. And, you know, these guys will come to you and you'll complain about what I say, but I'm telling you, if you listen to me, you'll learn.
And I don't care personally. You're not going to
see it from my house. If you don't care, why are you turning this into a big argument?
No, it's not an argument.
Well, I said I knew what I was going to do. Okay. I had a handle on it.
You're just beating the dead horse, dude.
Oh, well, no. Hopefully
you got it. I heard it.
Smart, they learn.
Well, you know, it's drywall, man. It's not laying gold.
On the studio that I'm doing for right now for George Clooney, because it's got a lot of weird angles and all that, I hung all the rock myself. I work on places like they're my own home.
We're about getting the job done. We're not working on a $1 million home. We're not working on George Clooney's house.
I just don't want to see sheetrock taking time because sheetrock is brainless. Anybody can sheetrock.
Yeah, but you got to teach them to do it the right way, homie.
If you sheetrock's every day, you do.
My motto is to teach a guy the right way.
My motto is to get it done. The sheetrock
okay.
is mudded.
Well, you know what? It's all the same cut. Okay, so you're wrong.
Do we get to vote people off?
The boys tune out the doctor's advice and turn their attention to the post and beams. Over in the shipyard, Ken and Carl get started on the strakes and quickly realize doing it right is going to eat up a lot of time.
It's just something that you have to go through rib by rib by rib. You know, so if we have 18 ribs and each one takes us an hour, it's going to take us 18 hours to do the ribs.
Meanwhile, Dr. Wood is bogged down on the dock.
I'm not happy with my progress, and it has to do with a lot of different things.
We have done a mess of work, the four of us. He's still in the same spot, and he's explaining it to everybody. It's not this old house. Just do the work and get moving.
I don't really care what anybody thinks of me as a carpenter, because I have credentials.
Wednesday.
Hump
day.
The doctor arrives to discover there's no more teak to finish his deck.
Well, there's nothing I can do on the deck or the siding.
Give me 5 minutes to cut a couple pieces. I'll be up there. We'll talk about it.
Okay.
Well,
Ken suggests he use the downtime to start digging the fire pit.
I say you dig a pit, you dig a trench that goes around like that.
Right.
Say 4, 5, 6 inches wide.
Right.
And I say you mix up some mortar and you start setting rock in that mortar bed.
Right. Man, that's a lot going on there that I don't even do that.
Well, then why don't we pick something that you do? What is it that you can deal with?
Well, I can deal with pretty much, you know what? I'll start on this fire pit.
Okay.
I'll start on the friggin' fire pit.
I mean, dig a trench. It doesn't have to be that deep.
Right, I understand. I'm gonna humble myself because I don't do it.
Thank you for that.
Yeah.
The doctor picks up a shovel, but digging a ditch quickly dents his dignity.
Ken?
Yeah?
Everybody's kind of had some kind of like attitude with me since the beginning.
Well, dude, you're acting like a rock star. You're not playing
along. Well, you know what? I am a rock star, and so what?
Then great.
You know what I'm going to do? Well, I'm also a carpenter.
Okay.
And I got about 10 jobs in this area right now that you can go look at, physically look at them.
Dude,
okay?
It's not about
what I'm going to tell you is you act like a around me, I kind of like go ape, and I'll be on you all day. You know
cool.
what I mean?
Dude, cool.
Okay?
Cool.
It'll be uncomfortable. Don't be a kook, okay, from whatever city you're from, because I'm from here.
Okay, cool.
All right?
Good for you.
Right.
The lumber arrives, and before Dr. Wood digs himself into too deep a hole, he quits his pit and gets back to his deck.
The fire pit is a down and dirty thing. It's real primitive. It'll go fast. It'll go faster than the siding will go, so I want to get the siding out of the way.
Yale volunteers to pick up where Wood left off.
I'm going to kind of make it up as I go along. I've never done this before. What I was going to do is place the stones around and then start mortaring them in and just kind of basically build a wall.
Eric and Carl get into a groove on the boat, pulling two strakes together to form the bow. With his prow built, Ken sketches a head for his dragon.
Right now, I'm laying up all the wood to start carving the dragon head so that I can make all my cuts, do all my joinery, glue it up, let the glue dry it so I can hopefully start carving it tomorrow.
Get the chicken ready.
Today, homeowner Pete has decided to treat our crew to some Viking smoked chicken and ribs.
Cool smoker.
What we got going on?
Ribs and chicken.
Ribs and chicken.
Spare ribs.
Did you boil those things or just smoke them all the way? Okay, good.
Smoke them all the way.
Good.
Okay, I passed the first test.
You passed one test.
What about coating it with mustard before you cook
that can
it?
Be tangy.
Yeah. Keeps a little flavor in.
Make your own barbecue sauce?
I made my own rub. I used somebody else's, a combination of somebody else's barbecue sauces. So.
That's all right. Yeah, yeah. Okay.
So, it's all about the heat.
That's it. The heat and the smoke.
The heat and smoke.
All right, we're having some smoked meat.
Yeah, baby.
It's mid-afternoon, and Dr. Wood's deck is still not done.
Last piece going up.
Steve tries coaxing him into second gear.
We got 5 days. All I know is it took a whole day just to reframe that wall in, which is already wrong. It shouldn't have taken that long to frame the wall in the first place. And then whenever you're trying to, if you're trying to save all the material that's in there, like you're doing the other
dude,
day,
dude, I never
pick up the pace.
I never tore out a whole
pick up the pace. Pick up the pace.
These terrible tirades are taking their toll on the team.
I hate stuff like that. There's no reason for it.
I'm gonna be really pissed off if we don't win because one guy didn't pull his weight.
As if there wasn't enough on their plate already, Steve wants to add a system from Smart Home that will make the doorbell sound like a thunderbolt.
I have to get phone line, I have to get doorbell, I have to put speakers, and we have strobe lights. There's a good 4 to 8 hours worth of work here, so I'm a little worried now.
As darkness settles in, the boys work on the placement of the prow.
18-6. The piece you're using for the trimmer piece, need to cut that off so we can slide it forward another 6 inches, which is going to give us 19 feet.
But the team hits another snag when Steve spots a problem with Yale's woodwork.
So Yale's been doing the wood treatment in here, and on this side, everything looks great, and he did a great job. Basically, over here, it's not any rookie mistake or lack of experience, as some people would say. It's just you've been here 12 hours for 3 days straight, and it's an easy mistake to make. He measured from the floor without leveling from here, and you can tell by looking at it that it's off. But it's just, that's what happens when you're tired. I think Yale is mentally exhausted because he's had to struggle all week so far, and the work he's done has been fine, but he's just had to struggle emotionally with the outside elements in the build.
So Yale's got to rip it out and do it over.
I screwed it up, so I'm gonna fix it. It's gonna be fixed in about 15 minutes. And then we'll go do the whole wall. That's it, man. It's all yours, man.
Put the plumb stick on it, double check it.
Before you get nailed off.
Aye, aye, Captain.
Double check it. You just lack experience, like you're a salesman. If you had experience, you'd be just dialed because nice. You have all the tools, the mind, the fingers, the eyeballs, all that kind of stuff. The just mistakes you made are just mistakes of inexperience.
Thanks, man. Yeah, shut that door behind you, that'd be great.
Our shipbuilders get to streaking the hull, but the cool night air is working against them, making the boards too stiff to bend. So three of them head home. Once again, Ken and Dr. Wood work late, but tonight they do their best to stay out of each other's way. With just 2 days left, a fragile peace has settled over Viking land. Or is it just a calm before the storm?
Thursday!
$50.
Day four, and our noble Norsemen swarm onto the time-consuming job of bending strakes for the ship's hull. Dr. Wood saunters in. He gives the boat a free checkup, then heads inside to work on the banquet hall.
How's everybody doing out here?
You know, I wanted to tell you something about
the boat?
Yeah. Just between you and
right.
I want to share something with you. What I would have done is I would have cut my bottom out of plywood like that.
Right.
And then you hinge these things up. There's no gaps
there, in it. There's no way to make those planks
you,
form.
You know what? Let me
explain to you how it works, and then we're going to stop talking about it because I'm not going to listen
and
to you.
And then what you do is you do this round part.
Okay, I listened to you talk already. Now I'm going to explain something. How this works.
You don't know what you're doing.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, you're.
That's why I have this job.
You're a knucklehead, dude. You're from Tennessee.
Oh, what is that guy? I'm from Tennessee.
That has to do with you're not a California framie or a friggin'
transplant. You're a hack. You're a proven hack.
No,
as far as I'm
hack?
Concerned. You took 3 days on the year.
Dude, I would have bid something like
Shut
this.
Shut up, get back to
for,
work.
For I didn't take three
Shut
days,
Shut up and
dude.
Go back to work.
It's what comes out of your mouth.
Shut up.
Lame.
What's coming out of my mouth. Shut up. Go back to work.
I'm trying to share something with you, but your ego's too big to
it's
receive
not an
it.
Ego. You don't know how to shut your mouth and work.
No. You don't know what you're doing.
Four of us right here.
Get him the f*** out of here.
Okay.
The rest of the team is finally fed up with all the fireworks.
I can't believe there's somebody in the world like this.
But instead of meditating, they decide to do a little mediating. The team tells Dr. Wood that the drama has got to stop.
What we need to know is that, do you want to just kind of focus on your work?
Well, what am I not doing? I can't work and talk at the same time?
No. As a team, what's happening is that you keep digressing from what the project. And what we need you to do is we need you to focus and work as a team. We want to work as a team.
What you're doing saying I'm not focused, dude?
You're also screwing it up for us because you got everyone here upset. It's not fun to work around.
There's a lot of, and
well,
I hate to use it.
Talk to the boss. If you want me to
okay,
leave,
look,
the boss
he's
isn't on our team.
If you want me to split, I'll split. I mean, if it's that uncomfortable, I got three jobs within a half
hour.
Yeah,
it'd be great. We'd all love that. We'd love it.
It's probably better for us if he goes, honestly. We'll pick up the slack. We'll take care of his work, what he needs to get done, and we'll go from there.
He basically has offered and said if you guys wanted him to split, that he would do so. So I'm going to put it up to you now, and you guys talk about it, make the decision, and that decision is what we're going to do.
It's not working out.
Don't be shy. Don't be shy. No problem. Don't be shy.
You want to talk about it?
No.
If you guys want me to split, it's not working out, people's feelings are hurt, and feathers ruffled, and toes stepped on, I'll get down the road, dude.
That's not gonna split.
No problem. I have a different approach to this. Okay, so, you know, get down. Have at it.
And just like that, the doctor is out. With less than 35 hours left, it's now a four-man team. Ken goes back to his masthead, drawing a dragon onto the raw blocks of wood.
That is so cool.
Steve leaps into the void, taking over the Eye of Odin project.
Work on this big walk, trace this out for our Eye of Odin.
He traces over the projected image. Then does a little eye surgery on the giant wok. Yale starts on transforming a standard issue ceiling fan into a Viking relic.
So it's gonna be something like this here. It will look like an oar, and so it'll be a round wheel. It'll look almost like a shield.
But even if this build somehow gets done by tomorrow, the real question is, can we get the homeowners to give up the coachman?
Life in this amazing coachman RV is very good. We got some cool stuff in here.
Yeah, but it's not exactly roughing it.
We've got a huge fridge, stocks, plenty of beer. We got a fireplace here. I don't know, we haven't figured out if it's real, but it does generate heat. We
got the flat screen TV.
We have broadband internet in here. I mean, come on.
Pretty much everything we need.
Yes.
It'd be nice if it came with a couple more girls, but you know, hey.
I agree.
By 7, Steve is finishing the pit with a coat of fireproof mortar.
Our list just got a little bit smaller.
Ken's dragon head is shaping up, but he knows this team is still not out of the Dr. Woods.
We still have a lot of work to do and a long way to home.
They mount the dragon to the prow, and she's a perfect fit.
Looking good.
Okay.
Inside, Eric and Yale line the ceiling with thatch. And put a twinkle into the Eye of Odin.
In a good mood?
I like
in a
that.
Bad mood. Freaking out. Another accomplishment.
It's almost 9, and Ken is ready to put some fire in his dragon. He's cleverly built the head so it can be split in two to add a groove for the gas line.
That's gonna look great.
That's perfect.
We at least need to cut that one limb off. We really, really, really need to have that thing cut.
Mark it. And action. A little faster, please. Cut.
I hate this job.
Friday!
It's the last day of the build, and this team is going to need every second of it. The ship still needs a sail, a barbecue table, and a fire-breathing dragon. The dock needs a deck and a canopy. And the Viking long room needs a paddle fan and a banquet table. While Eric focuses on fine-tuning the hull, Carl steps over to Dr. Wood's stage.
I've been duly selected to be today's Dr. Wood and finally complete the platform that he started so many hours ago.
Inside, Yale tackles installing the smart home doorbell.
I'm still just installing the peripheral devices and getting the wire all to one location.
He's rewired the existing belt to play a thunderbolt sound effect that he downloads off his laptop.
That's a storm.
Wow, very cool. Very cool. Got the thunder working, huh?
Cool. Come back to work.
All right, so every now and then we like to play a trick on our homeowners. These guys are good sports, so right now I'm gonna have this RV taken away, and so when they come home today, they're gonna find that not only can they not move back in their house, but they have no place to stay tonight.
By late morning, Ken works out a way to securely mount his dragon head. Aboard ship, Eric adds a boat rail called a gunwale from bow to stern. As the afternoon slips away, our fearless foursome hurl forward.
Circle gets the square.
Where's the bloody camper? There were spears in there. Guess what? The coachman is gone. Chairs, your clothes, my clothes, everything's gone. So anyways, thought I'd give you a call. All I see is cones. And that was the first sign that seeing the cones and no coachman behind them is a bad sign. Have the ratings not been doing well lately to the exchange?
That's not the problem. We were in Vegas, but we didn't use coachman, and they got wind of it. And so today, they came by and decided they're going to take your RV. Now, I shouldn't be the one telling you this. What the producers are going to talk
to?
Well, I guess they decided to bring it back to you. Oh, man.
Home sweet home. Yes.
Wow. Somebody just took the wind out of my sails.
As the sun goes down, Ken fills the center of his banquet table with a mix of concrete and mortar. He's etched a Viking map into the wet tabletop. Then he gives it a Viking finish.
One, two, three.
By 8, it's ready to be moved inside.
Oh, God. Hold on a second, set it down.
But there's a problem. The concrete table weighs a whopping 600 pounds.
Watch it.
You in?
Turn up the weather stripping.
Oh, and there we go.
Guys, the Viking banquet hall is done. Done.
Step on the floor.
That's woo! Not us. Done, done, done.
Great.
Done!
With less than 3 hours left, they still need to raise a canopy over the Viking dock.
All right, we're done.
It's past 10, but this tired team still needs to launch their longship.
I would say probably 80% of the fixes on the boat are done. We're getting to the last ones. We're gonna make it happen, but it's taking a little bit of time.
Yale routes the gas line and wires the igniter. Eric and Carl install a charcoal grill in the ship's table, while Ken hurries to finish benches.
I'll be done with these in about 30 minutes.
With the gas line installed, they ease the dragon head into place.
Yeah.
All it needs now is Steve's stamp of approval.
It's all coming down to this boat. As far as just the aesthetics of it all, it looks good to me. So I'm gonna go ahead and say that the boat itself is done, but I need to see someone flip a switch and make this thing blow some fire. Not once, but I need to see it twice.
Oh boy.
And that's what it comes down to.
Deep breathing.
Nice.
Yeah. All right.
That's what I'm talking
we
about
have victory.
Now. Okay, but now I'm
one
nervous because it can work once. Let's make sure it's going to work again. Let's turn that thing off,
you
turn it on
doubt.
One more time. Come on. Fire. Come on. Be good to us.
Fire up.
All right, well, that's got to be fixed. That has to be fixed. You got 19 minutes to fix it.
Yale, let us know what we can do.
It's just an adjustment of a...
That sucks.
Nah, I got no. I have no idea.
There it goes.
Okay, turn it off.
Turn it off, and then turn it back on.
You want another one?
Yep, hit it again.
Turn it back on.
Yeah!
Yes!
All right!
Oh. There you go, buddy.
There you go.
3 minutes.
All right. Good job.
What
guys,
a week,
great
man.
Job.
What a
awesome work. Wow. Yes. You guys pulled it off in the face of all the craziness this week and the insanity. You know what? It came down to a four-man build team, and you guys kicked ass. That's all I can say. You guys rocked. You all get all of this from Makita, cordless combo kit, 10-inch compound miter saw and a top-handle jigsaw. From Aesop, the Trademaster cutting and welding outfit and the Mini-Arc 150 TIG and stick welder. And from Stanley, 151-piece professional builder's kit and Songs from the House by Dan Mackenzie. That's all yours, guys. Go check it out. Take your tools.
It's time for Monster Decorator Stuart Gilchrist to lead his team of daring decorators into battle.
So what do you think of my dragon? Looks great, doesn't it? Iceland this way in runic alphabet. So I found these chairs in an antique shop, but they were not covered in these hides. Straps are distressed. Someone's skull probably went through this. Yale did an amazing job with this fan. This is Pete's, and I'm using it. It's gonna go right here. It is exhausting. It's very stressful. We take absolutely nothing and turn it into a living environment. And I'm really proud of how all of this turned out.
Well, we're about to go into the house.
It's been a blast, 7 days.
Yeah, it's been fun. I have gotten more anxious today than I've been all week.
I think he's more anxious than I am.
I'm very nervous about this.
This is actually sort of a treat for me. My dad's here today with me. So I can't describe in words how cool that is. He's from Iceland, so for him to be here to see this whole thing with me, and especially considering the theme, it's real cool.
Monster!
After a long week at sea, it's time for Dane, Pete, and Pete's dad to find out if this new Viking pad is a conquest or a catastrophe.
Monster!
Out back, our builders watch on closed circuit TV.
Viking banquet hall.
This is awesome.
That is awesome.
How are you doing?
Wow. Look at that.
Look at this. Isn't that awesome? Look at this. Look at the roof.
Oh my God.
Come on around this way. Let me explain some things to you. This has your name in Monster House, etched in runes, right here in concrete.
Beautiful.
Can you translate?
No.
It's also the Western Passage. So there you go.
Wow.
This was made from just raw materials.
Beautiful.
This is the ceiling fan, your shield, the oars.
Jeez.
This is the Eye of Odin. Always looking down on the banquet, you know, the last dinner before your next voyage. And just so you know, this table probably weighs about 1,000 pounds.
Oh, wow. God.
So
great.
That is phenomenal. Beautiful.
Take care, Owen. Come on.
Isn't that something? Brand new hardwood floor. Textured walls. I mean, this room is, I love
real.
Look
at this. Jeez.
Look at the chairs.
Look
just
at
like,
that.
Just like it was in the old days.
Jeez.
You know, they got the maps. All this detail work is great. We didn't want to take away your shelves because I know you want it.
Not bad.
Hey.
Not bad
at all. Beautiful.
Well, let's move on out to your pier.
Oh, my God.
Oh, my God. This is your pier. And if you're gonna have a pier, you gotta have a ship on its way to the dock. And just because in true Monster House
form, fire.
That thing blows fire, of course.
That's phenomenal.
Isn't it great?
That's beautiful.
So how do you get into this thing?
Well, let's go.
Wow.
First you walk along the broken ice.
Yes.
This is, of course, your
fire.
Hey,
that's your cooking. That's your cooking facility.
Making a little stew in there right now.
Oh, my gosh.
And come on up. This is not just a ship. This is also a patio. We made it functional for you.
Oh, dude.
You got your new barbecue, some fish on the barbecue there.
Yeah, some white fish in there. These need to be filled with beer.
This is beautiful.
You like that?
Yeah.
There's one more thing. This is not just a sail. You want to go over there and give me a hand with this? Let's lift this thing up.
Oh, that's fantastic.
And now you got a little shade for your barbecue.
Wow.
Truck on.
What do you think about all this?
Unreal. I blown away.
You know, I love the fact that it just blows fire.
Now, how about the tree there? Is the tree okay? Is he going to be a little
crusty? It's fine. I wanted to cut the tree down. I wanted to cut it down. All right, come on out.
Nice.
So have a seat by the fire. Got a little stew burning in the cauldron right there. This is a lot of work for 5 days, but I've got 4 guys I want to bring out so we can thank them for a job well done and a hard week. Come on out, guys. Come on. Thank you.
Once again.
Yes, yeah.
Thank you.
Full job.
Nice to meet you.
One more thing that we should show you guys. Come on in. Have a seat around your table. Guys, come on over. Have a seat. Someone's here. Well, I think it's time for a good old Viking feast.
All right.
Yeah. All right.
Until next time, when who knows, the monster may be coming to your house.
Right.